The place they are building a mill now is the major sacrifice we have.
We can't put our pen on this paper until we can understand the importance of this plantation.
It's a $30 million mill, brings jobs to the community, brings revenue to the government. And some of the people are saying that it is a sacred site. The majority of people are saying it's not. The majority of people are saying go ahead with this.
People start coming from that way, they are flyers. I give here coming to pay a field laborer $10, you know, 50 kg.
I was an instructor before I could come to GVR. You know, the salary indeed they were paying all was none. It was not much and it couldn't meet our demands.
I have a late increase.
Here's how I left the job and I came to GVR. This country I will live in, we are in poverty, to be honest. Our parents are from a poor background. You find somewhere to put yourself, to see how best you can move your life forward.
I want you to take a look at the building. This is a classroom. No chairs. Students sit on the bare floor for lesson. This is a school cafeteria. GVS said after one period of working here, they were going to improve the schools, they were going to improve health sector, and none of these things have been done. GVS is now entering their fifth year. I'm trying to collect women and elders for the community meeting today. The meeting is all about our land. The issue of land is not one person saying. The entire citizen must give their consent.
Before GVR could come, we all were happy. They didn't come to the community in a peaceful manner. Government brought them all forcibly.
We need to come together and say the agreement we signed, we are not part of it. If you are taking the people land and you can't improve the living standard of the people, then why take the people land?
The government of Liberia at the time was very actively looking for investors in agriculture and in oil palm in particular as part of its poverty reduction strategy. It's certainly on our agenda to build the schools, but the land has to be developed before the infrastructure comes. Liberia is an extremely complicated and challenging country to work in, largely because of the civil war that it's gone through. So how can it basically bootstrap itself? Mining and agriculture.
GVR live very comfortable for many four. Poverty rate will be here, it will be more than before.
Most of the people are saying that they don't want for GVR to go. Now
I have master, I have, you know, AA. There is no job in Liberia here.
For me to see myself for corn be growing in my pan, but still I have to accept it because I use it to sustain my family.
You see this? See, you will grind the cassava and you will have this product. We eat it with palm butter, we eat it with gravy, we eat it with anything. It's a nice food. The women sell the cassava and bring the cash to pay our children's school fees, send out some that are going to college.
We hunt, we fish, we trap, and these are the things we do for our livelihood.
When the people come and take this land, you will not farm like this any longer. All of these places will be controlled by the investors. You can't farm here. You will not do anything here. They will take over all these places. They will plant their palm.
I think what does happen is that large-scale business coming into Africa is automatically labeled in certain quarters as being a negative and there to exploit rather than to actually do something positive, and we feel that we're trying to do a bit of both. There will be conflict, there will be disagreements over time, but ultimately they're essentially pulling towards the same ultimate objectives.
That place they build the mill is sacred. You will never see those places again. Let our people make decisions for their own land, because the land is our treasury. The land is our bank. The land is our life.